Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain about Gauss's law in electrostatics. This is an important law in electrostatics. In Gauss's law we have two forms, integral form and differential form. So Gauss's law is the net flux emerging from any closed surface is equal to the total charge enclosed within the surface. This is flux and this is the charge. Net flux emerging from the surface and charge enclosed by the surface. So the net flux emerging from any closed surface is equal to the total charge enclosed within the surface. And mathematically the Gauss law can be expressed as phi e is equals to phi e into ds is equal to phi e into ds cos theta is equals to 1 by epsilon naught into q. This is the permittivity of the free space and this is the charge. Here the flux means the presence of force, or you can say that it is a flow of energy through a surface. This is about Gauss's law, and next topic is Gauss's law in integral form. So now consider a charge q enclosed at the center of this sphere with the radius r, and now this q causes q coulombs of flux, hence electric flux density exists on this surface of the sphere. And also consider a differential surface area ds on this sphere. Let here an be the unit vector passing through this differential surface area in the direction normal to the surface of this sphere. So we can write ar into an is equals to 1, and we are going to use this in our derivative part. As I said that electric flux density exists in this sphere, then we can write it as d equals to epsilon naught into e. Keep this as our first equation. So from the definition of this sphere we can write e is equals to q by 4 pi epsilon naught into r square into ar, and keep this as second equation. Now substitute this equation 2 in equation 1. So we can write it as epsilon naught into q by 4 pi epsilon naught into r square into ar. So now here we can cancel this epsilon naught and this one. So we get d equals to q by 4 pi r square into ar, and keep this as equation 3. Now here apply dot product and ds differential surface area on both sides in equation 3, then we get as d into ds is equals to q by 4 pi into r square into ar into ds into an. This an, because we are having the an in the line of this ds, so now this and this will become 1 from this. So now write like this: ds is equals to q by 4 pi r square into ds, and keep this as our equation 4. So now here apply the surface integral on both sides. So apply surface integral on both sides, then we get surface integral d into ds is equals to surface integral q by 4 pi r square into ds. So take the constant outside, we can write it as d into ds is equals to q by 4 pi r square into surface integral into ds. Now this is our surface area of this sphere. So surface area of sphere is 4 pi r square. Now use this here, then we can write it as surface integral dds is equals to q by 4 pi r square into 4 pi r square. Cancel this, then we get surface integral dds is equals to q, and this is our flux, the total flux passing through the surface. So we can write it as flux is equals to q. This is our Gauss law in integral form. The next topic is Gauss law in differential form. So according to Gauss law, we can write it as phi e into ds is equals to q by epsilon naught. If we takes this epsilon naught this side, we can write epsilon naught into phi into e ds is equals to q. Now take this as our equation 1. So this let this q be the charge distributed uniformly over the volume V, and it becomes the density. I mean q is equals to density dou dv, and keep this as equation 2. So now use this in equation 1. We can write it as epsilon naught into phi into e ds is equals to density dv. Keep this as our equation 3. So now by using the divergence theorem, we can convert the surface integral into volume integral. That is, surface integral e ds is equals to div into e dv, volume integral. Keep this as our equation 4. Now substitute equation 4 in equation 3, then we can get epsilon naught into div e dv is equals to density dv, and this phi is true for any arbitrary volume, hence integrals must be equal. That is, epsilon naught into div e is equals to dou, or you can write it as div into e by taking this epsilon naught here, dou by epsilon naught, or you can write delta into e is equals to dou by epsilon naught. Take this as equation 6, and this equation 6, this is our Gauss law in differential form, and we can write in vacuum d is equals to epsilon naught into e, or e is equals to d by epsilon naught. We can write it as div into d is equals to dou, or delta into d is equals to dou. This is our 7th equation, and this is our differential form of Gauss law.